What's up, everybody? It's your girl, Sydnee Goodman, and if you didn't know, now you know. So today, I am obviously in a vehicle. Sydnee, where are you going in this car? Well, let me tell you, I am going to go learn more about beer. The specifics is I'm going to learn how to evaluate beer like a fancy person, which I am not. I'm so stoked. I really don't know much that's in store for me. I've made beer once. We went for Alex's birthday one year to like help brew our own beer, but honestly, I had no idea what was going on. It was Alex's birthday present, just kind of showed up and drank the stuff, and it was delicious.
Be terrific. You were making fun of me earlier.
I like being gorgeous.
Oh, there you go. That was fantastic. That was rough.
Almost.
Can I give it a try?
Yeah, go for it.
Thank you.
Glad you hopped
use
that
bar. My hard work.
Oh.
That was upsetting. That was upsetting.
Okay, it took a light touch.
Really know what to do with that.
I know.
Do you guys play
around?
Oh, hey.
Hi, guys.
Good, how are you?
Good. I'm Hi. Megan. So nice to meet you.
Hey, I'm Ben.
Nice to meet you. Hi, Sydnee.
Hi, nice so nice to meet you. Well, thanks for hanging out with me today. I really appreciate it.
I'm a trade brewer. I specialize in beer education. And today, we're going to give you guys all the tools and knowledge to become beer experts.
Oh, I love it.
I like being an expert.
What are you excited for? What are you expecting?
No idea what to expect, honestly, but I'm ready for it.
Yeah, I don't know anything about beer. I'm not even going to act like I understand. So anything you say will just be like imparting knowledge
for
and
sure.
Beer wisdom to
yeah.
me. So
that's perfect. Should we go ahead and get started?
Yeah, please.
Let's do it.
Are you guys ready to know your beer?
Yes.
Yes.
So
perfect.
Ready.
Perfect.
Yeah, this is really intimidating.
I know.
You guys will do great. There's no wrong answers.
Okay.
Just the wrong answer.
Got it.
So do you guys know the four main ingredients of beer?
Hops.
Yes.
Water.
Yes.
Slow down.
Wheat's in beer, right?
Sometimes. No, half sometimes. Answer.
Okay.
Sugar.
You gonna contribute?
I was gonna say hops, water,
barley. Oh my god, look at me! I
you're
know way
on
more
one.
Than
that. You're really good
one
at beer.
More yeast.
You got it.
What? Okay.
Wait, so it's water, hops, barley, yeast.
Yep, you guys got it.
Okay. I don't know that. Where that came out.
It's perfect. So today we're really gonna talk about all those ingredients and kind of how they overall affect the profile and a little bit about how the process kind of affects some of the senses that we're picking up. So we're gonna look at the aroma, the appearance, and then the taste of it. And throughout the process, you're gonna use all of your senses to figure out which one has more color, more aroma, and more taste.
Okay.
Perfect.
Pressure's on.
I feel like I'm very nervous.
You guys will do great.
Just when you have your first sip of beer, you'll be fine.
Yeah, absolutely. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to look at the beer, right? Kind of makes sense.
Okay.
And what we're looking for is the color of it. We're looking at the carbonation, really looking at how that malt really provides some of that great appearance. So you can take both of your beers, give them a little tap to kind of knock some of the carbonation off of the side.
I feel fancier already.
Perfect. And really take a look at them too. So focus on the color. Like I said, malt plays a really big player in this. If it helps too, yeah, hold them up to the light. Otherwise, you can use this white mat. It's a little bit easier to see it against some of the darkness that's going on in the bar. So
it's
take your
beautiful.
Time.
Okay.
It's very pretty. So tell me, how would you describe some of the colors that you're seeing?
He is definitely deeper in color.
Deeper caramel-y. In color?
A little golden.
Golden, yeah. Caramel.
This one's a little lighter.
Yeah. Perfect.
I don't know if I'm seeing the right thing, but this one is a little less carbonated than this one.
Okay, perfect.
Oh, what? No, I noticed that.
That was, yeah, that was a good call.
I did something good.
Yeah. Take your time. When you have come to a conclusion, feel free to use these guys, their little scratch off. So you guys have these Know Your Beer cards in front of you.
Okay.
So at every step, I'm going to ask you guys to scratch off whichever one you think has more of whatever we're on. So this one is more color. So
more color.
A or B, no pressure. Scratch off whatever one you think has more color.
Yay. More color.
All right, awesome. So the next thing we're going to look at is aroma. So kind of how we do that is we take our beer and we kind of swirl it around a little bit. That'll knock some of the CO2 out of solution and bring a little bit more of those aromatics to the forefront. Listen. It happens. Don't worry about it.
I'm so excited about
the beer. So swirl around a little bit. 80% of how you taste actually comes from the aroma. So it's really important to kind of really get in there. It's going to seem funny, but get in there, take a big sniff of it. And again, think about some of those malt components. So you should be getting a little bit of crackery, water biscuit, bread crust, a little bit of pepper notes from the hops, maybe a little bit of citrus. So smell both of them and then decide which one has more aroma.
Okay.
Give it a good swirl. Sometimes it's counterintuitive, but if you warm it up a little bit, that CO2 will come out of solution as well. So it kind of brightens up some of those aromatics.
Make your nose like stop. Like clean my palate of my nose?
No, that's a good question.
Do you just start breathing air?
Nope, so what you actually do is you smell the back of your hand and that'll ground you into your kind of, it'll reset your senses.
Nice smell of skin.
Yeah, so it's, I mean, that's what you're used to, right?
I'm really struggling with this.
Yeah, so yeah, like I said, feel free to cover it.
It's really? I'm literally not smelling anything from this one.
And it's
like, am I
now I'm confused.
It's all about how you perceive it. So if you are not really smelling one, go with your gut.
I'm gonna make a.
Oh my god.
You know, they both smell fresh.
I know.
Is that a thing?
It's a thing.
That's a thing? Like fresh? Like,
yes.
Like, what? Crisp.
Crisp, great descriptor.
Now I'm starting to smell.
Which one smells
stronger?
So, which one has more aroma to it? So again, think about all those beer characteristics. Think about kind of everything you're perceiving.
No, I which lost one the has smell in this one now.
More
so I have
aroma.
Okay.
Going with B.
Perfect.
Cool.
All right, we've talked about this long enough. Time for the best part.
Yes.
Time to taste it, right? Okay. So we always say take a big quaff, which is a really big drink of it. And you're gonna let it roll around on your palate for a little bit. You're gonna think about all those ingredients again. You're gonna swallow it and really think about the overall taste, the balance, that kind of stuff. Okay. So, cheers.
Are we doing A first?
Let's do A first, okay. Yeah. Well, cheers.
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 Prost.
Cheers.
Did you do the whole thing?
Oh. I thought it was a really big drink.
I mean, what? We have more.
But they said take a big drink.
Whatever.
Okay, I went for it.
There's no... So hopefully you evaluated that big drink.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
I don't know if I did.
We have some more here. Yeah. We'll give you a little bit more.
Yeah. So should I swirl it around?
Swirl it around.
Oh, I forgot to swirl it.
Yeah.
My bad. I got nervous.
Wait, can you give us an example? Like, how do you, as an expert,
like mouthwash?
Drink it.
You literally swish?
Yeah, so I put it in my mouth, kind of let it roll around in my palate for a little bit and think about the body of it, think about kind of all those tastes that are going on, and then swallow it.
Try it. Swish it.
I can't hold it for too long.
That's okay. We gotta start somewhere. All right. Do you guys have a good idea of the taste?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right. So same thing with B. Again, take a big sip.
Okay.
And then think about it. Let it roll around your palate a little bit. Okay. Swallow it. And then really...
I really good at rolling, like letting it roll around.
Mmm.
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 Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, like a 1 to 2 second roll is fine.
Okay.
You guys are like, 1 minute's good.
Yeah.
So, what are your
maltier thoughts?
Maltier.
Which one?
That's a
good word.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Maltier. Creamier?
All great descriptors. Yeah, absolutely.
I felt like I had more body.
Mm-hmm.
I tasted caramel.
Great descriptor. Yeah, those are all spot on.
A little heavier body than the first one.
Yeah, those are all on point. So, that being said, which one had more taste to you guys?
B.
Scratch her on off. All right, so for the big reveal, go ahead, scratch off.
Should we do it?
The bottom.
All together.
So,
okay.
Ready? B. was
Miller Lite.
Miller Lite.
What? Hey. That's something else.
Wow.
Yeah, really?
There is a huge, like, huge very difference. Definitive difference.
Yeah.
Huge difference.
That's awesome.
Is it what you guys thought?
Mm-mm. I actually, I'm surprised they're both light beers.
I know.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's the thing. Yeah. Because they were so different.
Yeah.
Yeah, they were super
What made different. You think that they weren't light beers?
Well, this one just had so much color. Like I said, it had so much body.
Well, it had more of everything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah,
more did. Color, more aroma.
Like, I mean, look at
us. Using your words?
All of us were BBB. Like, there's a reason why we're all BBB. More aroma, more taste.
And you know,
more color.
I wanted to go with A because it's A for Alex, but.
So, we obviously love American Light Lagers, and the crazy thing is Miller Lite has less calories and half the carbs, too. So, is that something you guys think about when you think about choosing your beer?
Well, sometimes. No. So, yeah, no, sometimes, actually.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, sometimes beer can make you feel really heavy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But also on the flip side, like, I don't like when beer tastes like nothing.
Yeah.
And so it's nice to have, like, a happy medium where you still feel light and refreshing, but then also has a good amount of flavor.
I just turned 30.
Or taste, good amount of taste.
So I do think about it. Because I, from the rumors that I get, it gets harder and harder to keep, you know, anything off once you become 30.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I can, like, I always am thinking about what I'm drinking, what I'm eating now, making sure that I am drinking as light of things as possible, mm-hmm. or, like, getting the best quality out of what I'm consuming, because mm-hmm. I don't want to overindulge anymore. If yeah. so, then this becomes this.
You get your beer gut.
You mind if I look at these real quick?
No, I have that. Absolutely.
You're saying this has less calories.
Less calories, half the carbs.
That's crazy.
Why is that?
The way that we brew it.
Oh. Really?
Wait, so do you actually brew the beer?
I have brewed the beer before.
Wow.
What?
That's so impressive. Cool.
That's cool.
I love that.
But what about the brewing process? Like, so you Miller Lite is very conscious of making sure that it's brewed so that these things are eliminated, so that you get the best possible beer with the less impact on your body.
Yeah, absolutely. So we are the original light beer, and we brew it in a way so you get the most taste. Along with lower calories and lower carbs.
Yeah. So the light beer has, it's specifically to do with the calorie content of the beer.
Absolutely.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Super cool.
Huh. Well, great. Well, thanks for hanging out.
Of course.
We have a little bit of beer left, so I feel like we should maybe cheers to
right.
it.
Right.
Cheers.
Yeah.
Fill her up with the B. Right, no, that's crazy.
Cheers.
Yeah. Cheers, guys.
I'm just gonna slowly consume this one so I enjoy it more. Yeah.
Oh, I
make it last longer.
Okay, so we just finished, and oh my gosh, you guys, I cannot believe that I haven't been drinking Miller Lite. I feel like an idiot. No, I couldn't believe that they were both light beers. I mean, I thought light beer was supposed to kind of taste like water, and beer B didn't. It was actually flavorful and nice. And I learned a ton. Now I feel like I'm a beer expert, and you guys can ask me all your beer questions and I'll try my best to answer them. Please don't ask any questions. Anyways, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and turn on notifications so you're the first to know when a new video drops, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.